On August 1st, 1987, Namco published ワルキューレの冒険、時の鍵伝説, or The Adventure of Valkyrie, The Legend of the Key of Time, introducing gamers to the fantastic world of Marvel Land. This action RPG was the 17th entry in the Namco family computer game series line that included many of the company's popular titles, including Mappy, The Tower of Juraga, and of course, Pac-Man.While the majority of games in this series were simply arcade ports of the Famicom, The Adventure of Valkyrie was an original property that Namco debuted on the system. The game would become a hit, most likely thanks to the excitement for role-playing and adventure games generated by Nintendo's immensely successful Legend of Zelda released on the Famicom earlier that year, as well as the appeal of the game's heroine, the titular Valkyrie. In no time, Valkyrie became one of the more recognizable and beloved characters in the video game world, at least in Japan, and her image would be found on all manner of merchandise and memorabilia.Valkyrie and her imaginative fantasy world would be used to sell things like school supplies, but they would also become the subject of game guides, adventure game books, comics, and a redemption-style metal game. Namco even translated the video game into a board game, something game companies did only with their most popular IPs. Due to the success of The Adventure of Valkyrie, developing a sequel was a no-brainer, and that's exactly what Namco started to do. Plans were made to continue the adventure not on the Famicom where the series started, but on a new platform, the MSX2 computer system.Early information and sample character graphics can be found in Volume 4 of the MSX edition of Disc Station, a disc-based magazine put together by the legendary minds over at Compile. There she is on the cover. This planned sequel was tentatively named ワルキューレの冒険2, Haruka naru toki no tobira, or roughly, The Adventure of Valkyrie 2, The Distant Door of Time. Well, as you already may know, we never had the chance to go through that faraway door, since Namco ultimately canned the project.All hope was not lost, however, and around the same time this cancelled sequel was in the works, a new and completely different game would debut in the arcade that would take the series to a whole new level and make Valkyrie more legendary than ever before, both figuratively and literally. The Legend of Valkyrie landed in Japanese game centers at the tail end of the 80s on April 21st, 1989, powered by Namco's popular System 2 board. This sequel kept many of the elements that made its predecessor so unique, mainly with its art direction and cast of heroes and villains.But it also expanded and improved on the real-time swords and sorcery style gameplay and just created an all-around bigger, better game, becoming an instant classic in Namco's rather impressive arcade library. Surely for most Valkyrie fans in Japan, it's this arcade title that's responsible for their love of the heroine and the series. Like Adventure, the popularity of Legend would grow beyond the chip, silicon, and cathode rays, but this time on an even greater scale, which is why Valkyrie has appeared on products and in other video games for decades now.And just as crafting a sequel to The Adventure of Valkyrie was a given, so was taking The Adventure of Valkyrie experience from the Game Center and moving it into the homes of people all across Japan. And that's exactly what happened. However, unlike a large catalog of Namco's arcade hits, The Legend of Valkyrie's presence on home consoles is surprisingly quite limited. From here on, we'll look at the handful of ports that The Legend of Valkyrie received throughout the years, and the different ways you can play them.If you haven't already watched my previous Import Gaming for the Win episodes on The Adventure of Valkyrie and its arcade sequel, I suggest watching those first to get the most out of this video. They go over the stories, characters, gameplay, and a bit of the history and lore of the series in some detail, so they should be helpful and hopefully enjoyable, particularly for those who aren't really familiar with the Valkyrie games. Anyway, without further ado, let's start with the very first of the ports, The Legend of Valkyrie for the PC Engine.Housed in a 4-megabit Q card, Namco published The Legend of Valkyrie on the PC Engine on August 8, 1990, about a year and a half after its arcade release. Similar to how Adventure was presented on the Famicom, it was one of many titles in the Namco line on the PC Engine, instantly identifiable on a shelf with its uniquely branded spines. Due to the differences in hardware between the PC Engine and the System 2 board, naturally the graphics, sound, and gameplay were scaled down for this home release. For example, in this version, the incredible sense of size and distance created by scaling effects are gone, and you can no longer take on the vast army of Camus with a friend playing as Kurino Sandra in co-op mode, making this a solo quest with fewer foes to test your mettle against. But despite the downgrades, this PC Engine port is still a great video game that retains most of the charm and magic from its arcade counterpart, and also introduces some new content that adds to the overall Legend of Valkyrie experience. While the arcade original is how many Valkyrie fans came to know and love the series in Japan, for me and many others who didn't have that opportunity, it was this PC Engine port that did it. Though I had played The Adventure of Valkyrie on the Famicom some years before, I didn't quite enjoy it at first and wrote it off as simply a lackluster game for a long time. Having always heard great things about The Legend of Valkyrie, I wanted to give the series another try, and the easiest way to do so at that time was with the PC Engine port, as it was and still is quite cheap and easy to find. My expectations were high, but somehow they were met and even exceeded, and I was so engrossed in the game that I completed it on my first playthrough in one sitting. It's because of this port that I revisited the Famicom title, finally coming to appreciate and enjoy it, which in turn led me to start this video series about Namco's Valkyrie games. I'm not the only one I know who became a fan of this series after playing the PC Engine port, and that's why instead of me gushing over The Legend of Valkyrie again in similar fashion to the previous episode on the arcade game, here's a different perspective from one of the best you can see and hear it from. My life in gaming's very own, Coury Carlson.
I'm not ashamed to admit that I joined this party embarrassingly late to the game. I was not familiar with the character of Valkyrie, nor any of her games. I don't doubt that I saw screenshots littered in the various magazines that I read during the time period, but nothing really caught my attention, especially since I wasn't a TurboGrafx-16 owner, and its lesser popularity in North America ensured that our chances of seeing it here were probably pretty slim. My true first experience with the character didn't come until decades later, when I found myself perusing the soundtrack for a Japanese-exclusive PlayStation 2 game called Namco Cross Capcom. I was initially roped in by the fantastic version of the Level 1 theme from Burning Force. But as I looked for other familiar tunes, I stumbled upon a soaring piece of music that I'd never heard before, and it was incredible. After digging for information, I came face to face with screenshots of Legend of the Valkyrie for the PC Engine. I had to play it. It looked exactly like the type of arcade action I was hungry for. So when I finally purchased myself a PC Engine Duo R in 2014, I immediately bought a copy to go along with it. Sitting down with it for the first time, my expectations were immediately fulfilled. Although I'm sure a number of cuts needed to be made to facilitate the journey to a home console, I was none the wiser, and having this version be my first experience with the game, I wouldn't have had it any other way. From its rendition of that first stage theme music, which some, myself included, would say is better than the arcade version, to the lavishly recreated character sprites, I feel that Legend of the Valkyrie is certainly one of the most impressive hue card games. As it turns out, this 1990 port was handled by the amazingly consistent Tosei, who'd previously delivered a similarly stellar version of Dragon Spirit for Namco a couple of years earlier. Dragon Spirit remained one of the best vertically scrolling shooters on the system, and had a key role in courting fans of the genre early in the system's life. This proved to be a good move on Namco's part. Valkyrie's mix of overhead shooting and platforming made a lot of sense on the PC Engine. It fit better here than it likely would have on any other console at the time. Which, I suppose, explains why there's no other ports of it during the console generation. While some of the truncated elements might be a disappointment for fans of the arcade game, such as levels 5 and 7 being streamlined into one level, certain magic spells being altered, and the obviously toned-down graphics, I feel that the additions and changes more than make up for it. As was typical of arcade to home ports at the time, a number of improvements and expansions draw out the replayability to justify the higher cost of entry. Additional dialogue and character interactions have been dispersed throughout the game to flesh out the world and your quest, including a boss battle with the Black Valkyrie near the end of the game. This encounter was slated for the arcade version, but was ultimately cut. Valkyrie can also level up her health and magic since your score now doubles as experience points. Finally, a much-needed password system has been implemented so you don't have to push through its fairly lengthy quest in one session. Although, you might find yourself so enraptured that you won't even need it, like Jimmy did. Although the arcade version proceeded to pop up in a variety of places over the course of the next decade and a half, the PC Engine version will get its well-deserved due before long. In 2006, the Wii's Virtual Console service was a huge moment for fans of 8 and 16-bit games. Each week, an assortment of titles would be made available for download. During its lifespan, there were some surprising additions to the service, not just in terms of games, but platforms represented, with TurboGrafx-16 and PC Engine making appearances early on. Valkyrie no Densetsu was among the titles to be released in Japan for the service. Depending on your point of view, the Virtual Console's adherence to representing the games in the most authentic way possible, right down to using the original 240p resolution, was either a benefit or a drawback. However, the PC Engine emulator seemed to buck this trend and at times can look a bit unsightly, with the combination of uneven scaling and a smoothing filter that bring to mind some of the worst multi-game compilations of the previous generation. Thankfully, the process for these types of things has been much improved by 2020, as Valkyrie no Densetsu deservedly found itself among the games on the M2-developed PC Engine Mini plug-and-play console. The game would also be commercially available to international audiences for the first time on the TurboGrafx-16 Mini and the Coury Mini iterations. Controversially, none of the included Japanese-exclusive titles on these mini consoles were localized. Still, the crystal-clear 720p output, paired with different scaling and scanline options, offer a great way to experience Legend of the Valkyrie for the first time. Just be sure to have an FAQ on hand for the more obscure dialogue segments. If a fully translated experience sounds more up your alley, then the great fan translation patch by Shanji and Cabbage is what you should be using. Of course, once the patch has been applied, you can load it onto various flashcards like the Turbo Everdrive or Super SD System 3. Another option is utilizing an emulator or Mr. FPGA for a more DIY experience. So while the PC Engine version of Legend of the Valkyrie hasn't been ported around ad infinitum like, say, Super Mario Bros., there's certainly no shortage of options available to you either. This is a game that is well worth your effort to discover for yourself, and is among the best that the PC Engine has to offer.
Thank you for that excellent overview on The Legend of Valkyrie on the PC Engine, Coury. And if you didn't know before, now you do. It's an excellent game that fans of the TurboGrafx, PC Engine, the Valkyrie series, Namco, or just fun games in general should seriously consider adding to their collection. But what about those who are looking for a way to experience something closer to what was presented in arcades? Well, luckily there were also a few direct ports of the original. The first of these wasn't published on a console, but rather for personal computers, and a decade after Valkyrie's arcade debut. MediaKite is a company that brought many classic arcade and console games to PCs in the 90s and early 2000s for the gamer on a budget. In 1999, The Legend of Valkyrie became one such title, released as part of their Super 1500 line, named so because each game retailed for 1,500 yen, or roughly 15 US dollars. This CD-ROM is designed to run on Windows 95 and 98, but unfortunately, the oldest Japanese Windows OS I have is XP, so I can't give it a fair or proper assessment as to its quality. But I can say that you probably won't want to play the game on Windows XP. Maybe it's a sound driver issue. Aside from this port, pre-smartphone-era cell phone applications of The Legend of Valkyrie were developed for use in Japan, and similar to the PC Engine port, the arcade title was made available on the Japanese Wii Virtual Arcade service. However, as is the unfortunate case with so many pieces of digital gaming content, these versions are no longer available to download and play without wading through legally gray areas of copyright law. If you want to play The Legend of Valkyrie in its original form but don't have access to these ports or an actual arcade board, or just don't feel like tinkering with emulators, there is another option. In the mid-90s, Namco started a series of compilations on the PS1 called Namco Museum, which would receive 6 entries in total starting from Volume 1 in 1995 and concluding with Encore at the end of 1997. It was with the second to the last title in this run, Volume 5, where Valkyrie would make her PlayStation debut. Published in Japan on February 28, 1997, this port of The Legend of Valkyrie precedes the previously mentioned PC port by 2 years. Namco once again called on the talents of Tosei Software to work on this collection of their arcade hits, which, in addition to Valkyrie, comes bundled with 4 other titles. The action runner Metro Cross, horizontal scrolling shooter Baraduk, vertical shooting classic Dragon Spirit, and the pseudo 3D Pac-Man sequel Pac-Mania. A lot of great games in a relatively small package. The version of The Legend of Valkyrie curated in Namco Museum Volume 5 is pretty much a straight-up port of the arcade game, with a few minor adjustments and options that help make it work better on a home setup. Perhaps the biggest change is the aspect ratio, which has been trimmed down a bit vertically with player info and score moved to a sidebar on the right part of the screen. This doesn't affect the overall game much, but if you prefer the original game's dimensions, you can make the switch in the options menu and play that way, so long as you also tilt your game screen or your head to the side. Other elements that can be adjusted include screen position, player 1 and 2 character controls, player hit points, life extension parameters, difficulty, and other less significant options. For players outside of Japan, perhaps the best thing about this port is the ability to play the game in English. It's not something found in the original Japanese release, but rather in the official localizations of the game. With the exception of the 6th and final entry, each volume of Namco Museum was published outside of Japanese shores, Volume 5 seeing a November 26, 1997 release date in North America, and a February 26, 1998 release in Europe. Over a decade after the development of the original Famicom game, Namco published the Valkyrie title in the West for the first time, and non-Japanese readers could enjoy the story in addition to the excellent gameplay. Aside from the language, the only difference between these Western localizations and the original Japanese edition is that the stylized stage names in the sidebar have been simply removed. One of the things that makes the original Namco Museum game special, and in my opinion still the best compilation effort Namco has ever put together, is a feature alluded to in its name, the Namco Museum itself. Each volume contains a 3D virtual museum that can be explored from a first-person perspective, which are filled with texts and artifacts that teach players all about the development, the history, and the features of the collected games. In Volume 5, the Legend of Valkyrie exhibit is located on the second floor of the museum, where you enter a portal that transports you right into Marvel Land. The exhibit is arranged along a forest path, dotted by wooden signs that allow you to view items of interest. You can look at pamphlets that were distributed to promote the game, instruction cards that accompanied arcade cabinets, the system to arcade board and explanations for its dip switch settings, instructions on how to play the game, and most interesting of them all, original storyboards and concept art for a few proposed sequences in the game, most which never made the final cut. Reaching the end of the road is a somewhat secret path hidden by some shrubs that takes you to a clearing in the woods occupied by a few of the heroes of The Legend of Valkyrie. Up high in the sky is the goddess, watching over the people of Marvel Land, and now you. Kurino Sandra and his family have gathered here, no doubt enjoying the peace that they helped bring to the world. And the star of the series, Valkyrie, sits upon a small hill, taking a much-deserved nap after her tireless and heroic efforts. A playable Legend of Valkyrie arcade unit is also installed in this area, though you can access the game from Namco Museum Volume 5's main menu, too. Just an aside about this portion of the museum, Namco has rarely ever put out any 3D renditions of Valkyrie, at least for public viewing, and the heroine's polygonal character model here, as well as her CG representation in the intro FMV, are among a small handful of such cases. Purchasing this game won't be much of a problem for those who want the Japanese version, as it's still rather cheap and also received the Best Hits edition, but the English language releases are a bit more expensive and hard to find. For those who just want to play the English version in some official capacity and don't need to own a physical copy though, Namco Museum Volume 5 is still currently available as a PS1 Classic download on the North American PlayStation Network store for PS3, PSP, and Vita for under $10. If you want the Japanese version in digital form, it can be found on the Japanese PSN for slightly more than its Western counterpart. Namco Museum Volume 5 is a great buy for anyone who wants a solid experience playing The Legend of Valkyrie, but the inclusion of 4 other great Namco titles and the bonus of the virtual museum make it a must-own, at least in my opinion. The Legend of Valkyrie is one of the all-time classic arcade titles that not enough people got to play back in the late 80s and early 90s, but thankfully the game has been preserved and is playable in a variety of ways for those who missed out the first time around. Whether it's with the excellent conversion on the PS1, the fantastic PC Engine port, or a more direct method of playing the ROM, I highly recommend experiencing the game by whatever means you can. Each iteration brings something new and different to the experience, so playing all three is actually preferable if you are or end up becoming a fan of Namco's Valkyrie series. Sadly, despite its impact on the gaming scene and its popularity in Japan, The Legend of Valkyrie never saw a sequel, at least as of 2020. There have been many Valkyrie cameos in other Namco properties, including a prominent appearance in Namco Cross Capcom as Coury mentioned, and there have even been a couple of spin-off titles in the series as well, but again, no true sequel. However, there is a bit of a consolation to that, with a 1998 project that combined some of the best elements of Legend and the original Famicom title, delivered in a rather unexpected form. But we'll talk about that in another episode of Import Gaming for the Win, the fourth and final entry in this video series on Namco's Valkyrie. Until then, thank you for watching this episode, and an even bigger thank you goes to Coury Carlson from My Life in Gaming for contributing to this video and sharing his love of The Legend of Valkyrie's PC Engine port. I doubt many of you watching this aren't already familiar with My Life in Gaming, but in case you aren't, you really need to check it out. It's seriously one of the best gaming channels out there. Anyway, see you around and take care. And hopefully Part 4 comes out within 4 years.